We're 4 full days now into the 12/21 scenario, and I have to report that today I feel a tremendous, unprecedented clarity. I feel that I've really pushed through, making a big push through, and widening the path, widening the path. The deluge of yesterday is over. We had this tremendous deluge. You could only say it was a monsoon here. The whole street turned into a river. And it was just amazing. I'd never seen it rain so hard here. At 2 o'clock, 2:30 in the afternoon, it was like dark, like night. The clouds were so heavy, the rain was so heavy, it was like nighttime. I went out and said, "What's happening?" I thought it was just an intense deluge. And I went out there and took video of it, and it was quite an experience. It was great. Today, crystal clear, beautiful, beautiful winter day, the day before Christmas. Woke up this morning with just tremendous clarity, and realizing that honesty is the best way, because honesty is clarity. Honesty is to accept reality as it is. That is honesty. And honesty is literally seeing. When we talk about spiritual seeing, we're talking about honesty, because honesty has the capability to literally see, to accept reality as it is. It also has the capacity to accept the intermediate step, which is the blessed version of existence, the hypothetical scenario of non-annihilation. It can literally see that is helpful and accept it. So literally, the greatest, the only way really to take the spiritual path is to be honest, more and more honest. Of course, this world is entirely dishonest. So you come in here in the world, it's extremely difficult to maintain your honesty. I was like so honest when I came in this world, people said I was pathological. I was pathologically honest that I simply couldn't tell a lie, and the world thought it was its duty to teach me how to be deceptive. And eventually I gradually, slowly caved in to that relentless pressure of the world, and then I got off track. But in being honest that I did get off track, that realigns me with honesty. That is honesty. And I've been able to see what this whole existence is about and what its plan is. It believes that it is possible to survive annihilation just by lying about it. By saying a lie that, yeah, we survived it. And then the lie will somehow survive the annihilation. So the ways of the world is to teach dishonesty, to teach deception, to teach lies. As Jesus said, the adversary is a liar, deceiver, and murderer from the very beginning, which is exactly true from the very beginning. So I was in church yesterday, and the homily was, the priest was talking about the Sandy Hook mass shooting, etc., and how terrible it was, and how fragile life is. I said, wait a minute, life fragile? Is that true? Is life really fragile? Wait a minute. There's a better response to it. Now, the response that I have given in previous videos is one that, of course, needs to be restated because it's so amazing, and yet it's just honest. And I'm getting back to the honesty that I had when I was young, which I simply could see. I had an extended range of seeing from the honesty. Honesty is seeing, actually. The fact is that everything that takes place in existence is a what-if scenario in a hypothetical place called the future. In other words, saying, what if this were possible? But the fact is, none of it is actually taking place. It's not real. None of it is real at all. Nothing that has ever happened here. So we have this mass shooting of children and some adults. It didn't really happen. What happened is, we said, what if this were possible? Let us play it out as if this were something that could happen to us. This is something that could happen in the future. In the future. All of existence is saying, what if this could happen in the future? It's not happening now. It's not happening now at all. Because if you're honest, you can see what's happening now, and then there's nothing is dying, nothing is threatened. Everything is flawlessly perfect right now. So we're saying, well, what if it could happen in the future? Imaginary place called the future. So no one has ever died. No one has ever been attacked. No one has ever been sick. This is a fact. This is an absolute fact. And if you're honest, you can see it. Honesty is literally the capacity to see what is. What is the truth? What is the truth? That's just honesty is saying, yeah, truth is true. That's honesty. And you can literally see this. And it's the most powerful path there is. It's the only real way to accept reality as it is. You have to be honest. You can't say, well, what if it weren't true? That's not honest, because it is true. You say, well, what if it changed? That's not honest, because if you look at reality, you say it can't change. So you have to say honestly, it cannot change. So the real response to these atrocities and these terrible things that seem to be happening is honesty. And to be truly honest, we have to say that nothing has ever happened here and nothing ever will happen here. And we're free to exchange this nothingness for a blessed version where of non-annihilation. In other words, what if reality couldn't be changed? And then there's a blissful, seamless, where we realize nothing's dying, nothing's being harmed, nothing's being threatened. It's a blessed version of existence. That's a hypothetical, and we can make the exchange. Honestly, we'll say, yeah, of course we can make the exchange. Now, the reason I came into this world and what I tried to do is to tell people, I'm not really here. I'm not really here. I have appearance here, but I'm not really here. And in fact, you aren't really here either. But I failed in that, because the world was too relentlessly demanding, and it gradually wore me down. By the age of about 12 years old, I finally slipped, as it were. Which is okay, because almost everybody slips. It's very rare that anyone come into this world and maintain their perfect honesty here. Very difficult. So I've been trying to recover it ever since. And I'm still working on it. So what I want to do, what I came to do, is to say, there's an appearance here in this hypothetical place called the future, but I'm not really here at all. And the laws of this hypothetical don't apply to me really at all. They don't apply to you either. And you're not really here either. Nobody's really here. No one. Absolutely not. This existence is really nothing. Nothing at all. Nobody's here. Including existence isn't even here. It's not that we are no identity dwelling in a real world. No, that's not true at all. The world is not real. It's all hypothetical, all of nature, everything, time and space, totally unreal. It's only a what-if scenario. What if this were possible? What if time were possible? What if space were possible? What if forms were possible? What if all this activity were possible? What if all this threat and dying and destruction of form were possible? What if all this were possible? But it's not possible. It's not possible. It's not. It's only what if it were, but that's dishonest, because it can never be possible. Can never be possible, because reality can never be annihilated, can never be changed in any way. So the way to teach is to be in the world but not of it, which is what Jesus said. I'm in the world but not of it. Be in the world but not of it. Meaning have an appearance here, but show everyone that you're not really here. So they crucified Jesus' appearance, the body, but the spirit was untouched, and then resurrected the body, saying, look, you see, this was just a demonstration to you. That this is all what if scenario. What if you were a body? And he said, but you're not. You're not a body. No one is. No one's really here. And as we continue on with these cycles of birth and death, it's all just be dishonesty. We're just practicing dishonesty. The world is full of deceit and dishonesty. And I'm seeing now that the idea is that through ultimate deception, we can survive annihilation. Through ultimate lying, they're reaching a state of perfect lying, that somehow we believe that will enable us to survive annihilation. So there are very attractive formats attracting us to deception, attracting us to lies, saying that this is the way to go, this is the way to go, this is how to succeed. Well, certainly, hypothetically, that's the way to succeed, but there is no way to succeed in this situation, because there is no annihilation. In the first place, the only way to succeed is to recognize this is all completely unnecessary. So if you took it that annihilation was real, then you would have to say, well, we just have to come up with, deceive ourselves entirely that we're not annihilated. Because if reality were annihilated, we would be annihilated too. So what we're trying to do is come up with a perfect deception, perfect lie, and say, and deceive annihilation, as it were. That's really what it's trying to do. So of course we attract ourselves to this path, and there's some very clever ways that, which is what happened to me. I got targeted very severely by this grand deception, because I was telling the truth, and the truth here is an anathema. I was super honest, and that's an anathema here. People feel that the whole situation is being threatened by honesty, because the success that the world is looking for is total deception, total lie. As if we can deceive reality itself by just saying that reality is unreal, and therefore the annihilation is unreal, and therefore we survived it. Not true. There is no annihilation at all. So only perfect honesty prevails in this world. If we try to do it part way, then what happens is deception targets us very severely, and we gradually get pulled down. So it's super important to speak the unadorned, honest truth here. And just that's the only way to really gravitate back towards making first the intermediate step, exchanging hypothetical scenarios, and then finally putting that hypothetical scenario down, realizing annihilation is not an issue at all. One has to practice honesty. The more honest one is, the better one can see. And if you're willing to be really super honest, then you will start seeing super well as far as how to, what the situation here really is. That you can simply have an appearance here, but not really be here. And then your appearance here is supported by honesty. And honesty recognizes that you're not really here, and that you're not here for deception or for lies or for attack or any of that stuff. And it supports your appearance here. It supports your appearance here. This is what some people call the grace of God in the world, that you're cleaned. Everything is cleansed. All dishonesty is cleansed, and you are able to show people that you're not really here, and this whole scenario is not really happening. And it seems like that things happen in a miraculous way because of that. And some people have experienced that, but they don't explain it in the full context of the situation very well. I've noticed that. So that you'd seem to live in a portable paradise, where everything, it seems to, you don't seem to be touched. The world just doesn't seem to really touch you at all, because your purpose here is not to be touched by the world, but to witness that you're not really here. See, not really here. Because you're not. No one's really here. So the only way to be saved is where people realize they're not really here. This is all hypothetical. This is all an imaginary place called the future, where all this stuff is, we're saying, what if this could happen? What if it could be a massacre of children? What if? And so we play it out. Everyone plays it out. Those involved are also playing it out for them, for their own deception, really. All death is the play of deception. It really is. It's saying, what if this form could die? What if in this way? What if this were possible? What if this were possible? What if annihilation were possible? What's going on here? What if annihilation were possible? Then how would we be able to survive it? So there's different facets of this situation where there are many who play the role of, look, you see, I'm being annihilated, therefore I'm witnessing to you that it is possible. You see how that works? So one who comes here to only give an appearance, they're not witnessing that annihilation is possible. Being honest, so annihilation is impossible. Therefore, they have this grace that goes with them, a portable paradise that goes with them. Now, Jesus allowed his body to be annihilated just to demonstrate what everyone was trying to do, and to show it was futile. It was absolutely futile. That's just one way to demonstrate it. There are many other ways to demonstrate it. One does not have to do it in that way at all. And I don't have any desire to do anything like that. So I prefer the portable paradise situation where people recognize, wait, how are you getting this? And you say, well, it's just being honest. Just honest. The more honest one is, the better. And we're talking about an honesty in depth, an in-depth honesty about this whole situation. It's unreal. It's not taking place. It's not really taking place at all. We're like projecting a movie, what if movie, what if this were possible, what if all these things could take place? And so you say, you ask, well, what about the people who get killed in these massacres? Well, literally, they are allowing their participation in that to give witness to their belief, what if annihilation were possible? What if it what if annihilation came about very suddenly and unexpectedly and tragically, just absolutely, you know, horrible, no warning. Then what, you see? Which is really many, many ways we model annihilation here. And then there are those who do the annihilating, and there's those who succumb to the annihilation. It's all an attempt to keep being dishonest, really, saying that annihilation is possible. Annihilation of reality is possible. Annihilation of what we truly are is possible. It's not possible. Not possible. In any way, shape, or form, is totally impossible. So just be honest. Honesty is the path. It's if you can just try to be honest, you'll find that, wow, the whole thing, suddenly realize I'm not really trapped here. I'm not really trapped at all. And as far as your appearance goes, honesty will support your appearance here. And that is what I am looking forward to. And it should be a great experience for me, is to reestablish that connection with honesty, the full honesty, which I used to have, which enabled me to literally see. I could see into the future. I could see the subtle levels. I could see. And people hated that because I would tell them what's going on. They say, no. I say, wait a minute. Somebody's setting up a trap for you to fall into. And they say, no, we don't want to know anything about that. You're ruining everything. I say, what? They said, yeah. Because they want to give witness to annihilation. They want to say, look, you see, look how I was tricked and struck down like that. You see, annihilation can happen. So they don't want to be forewarned. Most people in the world don't want to be forewarned. They don't want to see the traps. I could see the ETs, what they were doing. I could see the subtle realms. And I said, hey, folks, they're sabotaging the whole planet. You're going to be in big trouble. And people said, no, don't tell us these things. We want it to be a surprise. We want to be surprised by it. We want to be fall into those situations. They want the challenges. They want to be faced with these severe difficulties, thinking that one, annihilation is real, and two, they can work on the challenge of trying to survive it. They can work on their own deception and cleverness and deceit and dishonesty, thinking that if they can just be entirely deceitful, that somehow they will survive it. So they didn't like honesty at all. Time and time and time again, I would just tell people, this is what I see. This is what I see coming. And they'd say, you're ruining it. And they get real mad at me. And then it would happen. I'd say, I told you so. And they'd say, get out of here. We don't like you. So I wasn't given welcome in this world at all. Really. You cannot expect welcome in this world, really. Because the world is too enmeshed in dishonesty and deceit. In this hypothetical scenario, believing that it's necessary, that they feel they have no use of honesty. Of course, basic, following the law and all this kind of stuff. They say, oh yeah, they emphasize that, but I'm talking about a much deeper honesty. Much, much deeper honesty that literally enables you to see what's going on. You can literally see the future. You can see everything. It's possible. And yet, of course, it's useless because people won't listen. They don't want to hear it. And then what happens is you get mixed. You try to mix honesty and deceit together to make it more palatable for people here. And then you start not being able to see properly. And then people say, you can't foresee things anyway, because they try to make it more palatable here. Because you don't really want to tell exactly what's happening, because people will hate you for it and won't accept it anyway. It's a very, very crazy situation here. But the way out is simple. Just practice extreme honesty with yourself. With yourself. You don't have to go into the highway patrol and say, hey, highway patrol, I went 67 miles an hour on the freeway yesterday. I want you to give me a ticket. We're not talking about that kind of ridiculousness. No. We're not talking about following the law to a letter, to a T, never going over the speed limit, always waiting 3 seconds at the at the stop sign and all this kind of stuff. No, we're not talking about that. We're talking about honesty with yourself, about what is true, what is true, what is true, what is truth, what is reality, what are you, what's going on, what is existence. Just be honest with it. And that's the way that I teach that. That's how I'm seeing opening up. This whole thing is opening up. I say, my gosh, it's possible that I can start functioning once again. Just an appearance here. Just an appearance here. And know that I'm not really here at all. And the way that I see it as simply being honest, for me, is the best path possible. I don't feel attracted to other paths. I really do not. I try to be, but when I look at them and look at them, I see, gosh, the fullness of the context simply isn't there. It simply isn't there. They don't talk about exchanging hypothetical scenarios. They don't talk about then setting that hypothetical scenario down. They don't talk about simply the clear delineation of appearance here, but not really here at all. They don't talk about the world. There's never been here. There's some talk, but the fullness, richness of the context is lacking. And I say, you know, it is possible to have the whole thing, to see the whole thing. If you're just willing to be entirely honest, truly honest, you can see the entirety of the situation. And it's very, very simple. And the pragmatic thing is, how do you have an appearance here? Knowing you're not really here, how do you function, et cetera, et cetera. And people get tripped up by that. And that's what I hope to be able to model better. But the first thing is, you have to realize that it is possible, and that our questions about how is it possible, literally, we need to be more honest with ourselves, and then we'd be able to see how it's possible. How is it possible? And so I was working on it this morning. How can honesty clear up your debts? How can honesty clean up your life? How can it do all that? Well, it can't. It seems like there is a way for it to do that. I'll have to see how that all takes place, because we've all been enmeshed in deceit here in this world. So how does honesty clear up this deceit for us? Because deceit leads us, ratchets us down. We're dishonest here, and then we have to cover it up with a greater dishonesty, and then a greater dishonesty. If you follow that path, you find that you're being educated in how to be an extreme liar, an extreme deceiver, and that it seems like in this world, that gives you more and more power, more and more power. The better liar you are, the more power you get in this world, the more control you have over others. And it seems like a successful path. But you have to keep doubling down and doubling down. So you end up just becoming more and more wicked, more and more wicked, more and more deceitful. And you say, wow, there's something wrong. This is not good. And you're not really sure what's going on. But from looking at it now, it is the strategy of how to survive annihilation. That is literally the strategy. Is just to try to come up with some ultimate deceit, which is to say, you never were part of reality. So even though reality is annihilated, you were never.